Americans and your allies. Armed Forces Radio brings you a special rebroadcast with Victor Young and the orchestra, the Ken Darby Singers, John Nesbitt, and America's beloved baritone, John Charles Thomas.
Dear friends, this is John Charles Thomas. Well, here we are again with another half hour of song, story, and music for you men and women in the armed forces of the United Nations. For story, we have John Nesbitt, one of America's best. For music, there's Victor Young and the orchestra. And for song, the Ken Darby chorus and myself. And now, Vic, with the preliminaries over, let's get started. There's a powerful poem by Edmund Goulding, which was made into a song by our old friend Frank Tours, called Fury of the Sea. I'd like to sing it for you.
Breathe in my soul the sleeping ocean. Wake me with a red gold hope at dawn. Shroud me in my evening with a bubbling fleece on whose broad rolling bosom then, when attack of wind or will shall mar our lay and frown upon our glee, screaming we'll rise and crouch and kill. Oh, fury of the sea.
Attending the program today as our guest is a very well-known Mexican composer, Miss Consuelo Velasquez. One of her great compositions is a lovely song which has become practically world famous. And Victor Young, as a compliment to her and to our good neighbor Mexico, now plays it, Bésame Mucho.
Thank you.
Here's an old favorite I'm sure most of you know. In the Garden of Tomorrow. Ken Darby has one of his song combinations today, which he hopes will revive some pleasant old memories. They Go Wild Over Me and Melancholy Baby. Ken, let's at it.
Melancholy baby, the door opened on me. baby with your melancholy. All the other gals are jolly, and besides, they go wild, simply wild over me. I'll be twice for a place upon my knee. I'm an A1 Army guy, that's the one big reason why. They go wild, they go wild, they go wild, they go wild over me.
If from time to time John Nesbitt has told some tall stories from his passing parade, he meets his master in the true story of the man he is going to tell us about today. So now, John Nesbitt.
It is the year 1872. Ulysses S. Grant is president of the United States, and Queen Victoria rules in England, and Napoleon III rules France. In a dark, quiet room in one of the little crooked side streets of Amiens in France, there sits a handsome, bearded Frenchman. He is bent down over a desk, and he writes as fast as his fingers can move. He is known throughout France and most of the world as one of the great travelers and explorers, for he's written many books of travel on Russia and South America and the United States and Mexico and the polar regions, all with such accuracy that critics always comment upon the excellence of his observations. And yet, actually, this man has seldom stirred outside of the dark room or the narrow streets around it. But he is simply possessed of one of the most astounding imaginations ever owned by a human being in the history of the world. 46 years before Admiral Perry reached the North Pole, this incredible Frenchman had written a complete description of almost precisely what Perry saw when he finally did reach it. 60 years before William Beebe became the first human being ever to reach the depths of the sea, half a mile below the surface, this Frenchman's imagination had filled a book with an accurate description of what the sea bottom ought to look like when man finally saw it. Other books he filled with descriptions of inventions which did not come about until long after his death. Airplanes and helicopters and talking movies, color photography, automobiles, submarines, plastics, television, atom smashers, the 16-foot telescope on Mount Palomar, California. He made such a startling prediction of the Germans' Big Bertha cannon of the last war that many people sincerely blamed him for giving the German engineers the idea of building. And his name, as you probably guessed, was Jules Verne. In Brazil, a boy named Alberto Santos Dumont read his story called 5 Weeks in a Balloon, and he became fired with the idea of conquering the skies and later designed a monoplane, one of the very earliest of its type. In Pleasantville, New Jersey, an American boy named Simon Lake read Jules Verne's 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, and according to his own statement, he received from that book of fiction the idea that became the modern submarine. Admiral Richard Byrd says that Jules Verne's story, The Sphinx of the Ice Fields, was what started him out on his determination to explore the South Pole. Dr. George Hale, who labored for years to promote the building of the Mount Palomar telescope, must certainly have read those wonderful books as a boy. How else could he account for the fact that the 200-inch mirror of that telescope is almost precisely the exact size as the one described by Jules Verne in a book called From Earth to Moon? Yet, of course, there have been several of these prophets who saw clearly into worlds that were to be born centuries after their deaths. 400 years ago, an old woman named Mother Shipton was busily predicting moving pictures and submarines, airplanes, automobiles, and traffic tubes under rivers. 1,200 years ago, a blind girl in France, Saint-Odile, was describing a war that would take place in the future in which cities would be bombed from the air by men riding in mechanical birds. Many of the things that were foreseen more than 3,000 years ago, engineers and inventors are working toward this year in 1944. Jules Verne's atomic energy machine, in which a kind of pill the size of an aspirin tablet would drive an automobile across the whole country and back, may really come to pass sooner than we realize. At some of the research laboratories of America, you can see the great atom smashers that have already vindicated one of Jules Verne's wildest predictions. He said that we would one day be able to change lead into mercury and then change the mercury into gold. And it actually can be done today. and it is almost terrifying to realize what may come tomorrow. The future blazes with power. 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 If we dare to seize it and to master it and use it well. And undoubtedly, that tall and slender and bearded Frenchman, in the dark room which he almost never left, writing of things that no man had ever seen or done, Jules Verne was one of those who saw our future better than most geniuses who have ever marched the passing parade.
Thank you, John Nesbitt. When they begin, the beginning, it brings back the sound of music so tender. It brings back a night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen. I'm with you once more under the stars. And down by the shore an orchestra's playing. And even the palms seem to be swaying. When they begin, the beginning.
To live it again is past all endeavor. Except when that tune touches my heart.
There we are, swearing to love forever, and promising never, never to part. What moments divine, what rapture serene, till clouds come along to disperse the joys we had tasted. And now when I hear people curse the chance that was wasted, I know but too well what they mean.
So don't let them begin the beginning. Let the love that was once a fire remain an ember. Let it sleep like the dead desire I only remember. When they begin,
when they begin,
when they begin, begin the beginning.
Oh yes, let them begin the beginning. Make them play till the stars that were worth before return above you. To me once more, darling, I love you, and we suddenly know what heaven we're in.
When they begin, the beginning, we'll find that old happiness when
they begin.
Now, as another gesture of goodwill to our neighboring republic, Victor Young plays the brilliant El Relicario.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to have a 4-week leave of absence. While I'm away, the fine young American baritone Lee Sweetland will sing for you. You may have heard him once before on this program. In my opinion, my friend Lee, with his beautiful voice, is destined to have a great singing career. So be sure to listen in next.
I'll see you again.
To begin with, if you please, sing a scale for me.
La 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la.
Tut tut tut, you can do better than that. Take a breath and then reprise in a different key. Come, come, come.
La 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 la, la 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 la, la la la.
All my life I shall remember knowing you. All the pleasure I have found in knowing you. The different ways that one may praise. Across the air.